What's up guys, today I'll be showing you how to increase your resonance power as much as possible during the Empyrean Foundation in the quickest way possible. This method will not include any crazy reinvesting strategies or anything like that. Even if you already donated your entire reserves, this will work perfectly fine with you. And this is going to be a way outside of reinvesting to increase your resonance power as quick as possible. Before we get into that, we just recently completed stage 3. And the stage 4 goal came out at 2.2 billion, which is a big deal because our original predictions led to a 5.2 billion stage 7, but this does not follow the original predictions at all. And the best fitting pattern we can find will result in 11.8 billion stage 7, which will be more than double our original prediction. And I personally think these numbers are just mainly controlled, so this might go even higher. Anyways, this method to increase your resonance power as quick as possible will revolve around buying light fused fractaline, which is the new exotic consumable that costs 20,000 glimmer, then also 10 legendary shards. And when you buy one, you can upgrade any obelisk by one rank, which then means resonance power goes up by 100. But let's say you don't have infinite amount of glimmer stored up, or you don't have that many legendary shards, or don't want to really eat into your current amount of legendary shards. So in this video, I'll show you guys a way to get infinite amount of both of those materials and never have to dip into whatever you have saved up over time. And what you will be doing is doing the sundial. And as long as you have all your different obelisks and season pass things unlocked, you can now get 5 items per run. So that means 5 weapons plus 1 armor piece, so 6 total legendary items. And what you're actually going to be doing with all 6 of these items is you're going to actually delete them every single time, which means you get 4 legendary shards per legendary item you dismantle, which means a total of 24 per run. And if you remember, the light fused fractaline only costs 10 legendary shards and also 20,000 glimmers. So now we have 24 shards, so we have more than enough shards. And now all we have to worry about is the glimmer part. So you're going to take those extra 14 legendary shards that you have left over and go to Spider on Tangled Shore and do a bunch of different material conversions to get as much glimmer as you can with that extra 14 shards. With that extra 14 shards, you'll be able to buy 70 of any material you want. Then with that 70 material, you can turn around and buy 35,000 glimmer, which is more than the 20,000 we need to be able to buy one light fuse fractaline. So depending on exactly what Spider's inventory is that day, there might be an infinite conversion of, let's say, buying Dusklight for shards, then buying Glimmer for Dusklight. So on days like that, you would just do that infinite chain over and over again. But on other days, you can just prep for the future by buying any of the materials for shards. Then in the future days during the event, there's a high chance that he'll be selling Glimmer for one of those materials. And on that day, that would be when you farm a bunch of Glimmer, then buy a lot of the things in the tower. So this part will change depending on exactly what Spider has. And you can wait to do all these conversions and buy all the light fused fractaline on a day that makes sense for you. And in the meantime, just farm sundial a bunch to get the legendary shards ready for that day. So every sundial run will give you enough materials to buy one light fused fractaline. And when you buy that, you take that to an obelisk and you get a full rank up at that obelisk, which would normally cost you 200 fractaline. So pretty much every single time you buy one of these consumables, you're pretty much investing the equivalent of 200 fractaline at an obelisk. So another way of thinking about this farm is pretty much every time you do the sundial, you're getting the equivalent of 200 fractaline. Then on top of that, you also get guaranteed 10 per run. Then if you have the Nessus Obelisk fully ranked up, there's a high chance that you're going to be getting 100 per run. So worst case scenario, you're going to get the equivalent of 210 fractaline per sundial, or all the way up to 300. Which is going to be much more efficient than doing something like Strikes, Gambit, or Crucible, where you only have a chance of getting 100 every few runs, and there's a high chance you just get 0. But with this, every single sundial run, which takes 10 to 15 minutes, you're guaranteed 210, then also potentially 300. So this is definitely the way to go after you've already done all of your weekly and daily bounties. And you might even be able to argue that this is going to be more efficient than even doing the bounties in the first place. Anyways, I just want to talk about the investment strategy real quick and give a quick updated guide about it. The most efficient way of investing is still invest the first 2 weeks, then start donating the last 3 weeks. And if you do that, you will still be getting over 50% more total donation throughout the entire event, which not only will help the community, it will also help yourself because you'll be able to do more time loss bounties in the long run. The only main change that has happened throughout the event to the investment strategy is now instead of doing the reinvesting on Tuesday reset and taking your harvest right away, what you can do is wait until the end of the week on Monday night or Tuesday morning to take the harvest because your resonance power scales up throughout the week as you farm more and more things. And you can harvest your resonance power once per week, so you may as well do it when your resonance power is as high as possible. So doing it Monday night, Tuesday morning, then quickly taking it and reinvesting it right back into obelisk would be the more efficient way of doing that. And do that the first 2 weeks. If you didn't do it this week, that's okay. Do it next week. Or if you've been donating and you kind of feel bad about it and wish you kind of invested a little bit more, well, this farm right here is the best way to raise your resonance power during the actual event itself and make up for that lost time of not investing. Anyways, let me know if you guys have any questions about anything in this video. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys next time.